In this video, I am going to explain important anatomical places around posterior part of shoulder. I want to focus on three nervous tissues today. First one is suprascapular nerve. Suprascapular nerve. Next one is axillary nerve. Last one is radial nerve. Let's get started from suprascapular nerve. This one is suprascapular nerve. It originates from cervical spines and it passes from anterior part of scapula. Then it shows up around here, just beneath acromion. This is acromion. And it turns around here. This is very steep curvature, right? This area. So, if people use scapular movement a lot, particularly scapular abduction, scapular adduction movement, maybe there's friction between suprascapular nerve and scapula. What happens to nervous tissue? There's a lot of stress around this area. What if nervous tissue gets damaged? That can create pain around this area. What kind of muscles does this nervous tissue innervate? Suprascapular nerve innervates supraspinatus and infraspinatus. Actually, infraspinatus covers posterior part of scapula, like this. So, suprascapular nerve goes deep to infraspinatus. Okay, this purple place is infraspinatus. Suprascapular nerve runs deep to infraspinatus. Do you see this relationship? Also, suprascapular nerve kind of bifurcates to the shoulder joint. There's two ways. One way is towards infraspinatus. The other way is towards shoulder joint. This nerve takes sensory information from shoulder. Again, what happens if this nervous tissue gets damaged? That can pick up pain information from here. Maybe this nerve can be one cause for shoulder pain. Okay, this nerve is important. It doesn't innervate a lot of muscles. However, in terms of sensory information, this nerve is very important. This is suprascapular nerve. Let's go to axillary nerve. Okay, I changed angle of picture a little bit. This is suprascapular nerve, right? Axillary nerve is this one. Axillary nerve. This nerve innervates deltoid and teres minor. Same like suprascapular nerve. Axillary nerve does not innervate a lot of muscles, but this nerve also takes sensory information from shoulder. Okay, so this nerve has motor function and sensory function. Very important, right? Plus, what is important about axillary nerve? Okay, axillary nerve emerges from tiny square space, this yellow space. This space is called quadrilateral space. Quadrilateral space. This space is composed by four structures. This one, teres minor. This one is teres major. This one is triceps. Triceps brachii. And humerus. Okay, that is why this is quadrilateral space. Quadrilateral means kind of rectangular shape. Teres minor, teres major, triceps brachii, humerus. So if one of these structures get damaged or fracture, space of quadrilateral space diminishes, okay? Or when humerus got fracture, that can aggravate axillary nerve. What happens when nervous tissue gets damaged? That can get paralyzed or muscle dysfunctions, joint dysfunction, right? Even in the normal condition, quadrilateral space is very tiny. Then, if each structures get damaged, that can even get narrower, right? Thus, quadrilateral space, so important for axillary nerve. Okay, let's move on to last nerve, radial nerve. This one is radial nerve. Key structure is triceps brachii and teres major. I'm going to explain radial nerve, okay? Radial nerve. Key structure is triceps brachii and teres major. There is triangular shape, triangular space here. What is this space? This space is called triceps hiatus. Triceps hiatus. Hiatus means a kind of space, okay? Triceps hiatus. You can palpate radial nerve through triceps hiatus. You can find kind of midline of triceps. You go up, you go up, you go up. Boom, you hit triceps hiatus. You feel space, you feel gap here. Now, you can palpate radial nerve through this space. Radial nerve is also easy to get damaged, particularly when people use a lot of arm movement, like hairdresser, like carpenters, or physical laborers. Many people use shoulder movement, right? So when radial nerve gets irritated, oftentimes there's pain around triceps brachii and thumb side, because this nerve innervates triceps and muscles on thumb side. Okay, it's very, very important nerve. Okay, I explained three nervous tissues today. Suprascapular nerve, axillary nerve, radial nerve. See, these three nerves are very close each other. So, if you can palpate, or if you know this anatomy very well, you can use this information for your clinical experience. You can use this info for your training, athletic movement, right? Three important nervous tissues are very close. Now you know you shouldn't push, you shouldn't compress this area. You can avoid risks to injure these nerves, okay? In this video, I explained three nervous tissues today. Suprascapular nerve, axillary nerve, and radial nerve. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.